Hello students, in this lecture we are going to study the TCP segment format. In TCP segment format, maximum size of header is 20 to 60 bytes header, right? Followed by data from the application program. We have in case of TCP format, minimum header size must be the 20 bytes, right? So we will going to see one by one all the fields of the TCP header. You have already done with the UDP header. In case of UDP header, it is very simple. It have just four fields, right? But TCP header is little bit difficult. Have more fields than the UDP field. You see, this is the source port address and destination port address. These fields are same as the UDP header of 16 bits. 16 bits means its maximum value will be 65,535. We have already done the discussion of the port numbers in the UDP, where we have done the discussion on 0 to 1023 are the well-known port numbers. Well-known port numbers are necessary for the server application, whereas client can use any port number ranges from 49,152 to 65,535. If server application's port number is not known previously, then it will create the overhead in the network. Client has to ask the first port number of the server application. After that, it will request for any information from the server. So that will create the overhead on the network. So that's why server applications, there are normally we have the well-known port numbers. For example, for FTP, it is 21. For HTTP, it is 80. For SMTP, it is 25. Right. After that, we talk about the sequence number. We already talked about the sequence number in the last lecture. Sequence number. However, there is a no sequence number is given to the segment. Sequence number, we already discussed that all bytes in the TCP packet are numbered, right? And sequence number, after the byte sequence, we have the sequence number. Sequence number is also a byte number, first byte number, which is carried in the segment, that we have already discussed in the previous lecture, right? For example, I have the packet or segment, you can say. I already told you each byte is numbered. In that case, if our byte sequence number is start from 1000 and my maximum segment size is 50 bytes, my segment is of the 50 bytes, right? In that case, for this packet sequence number is 1000, for next packet byte number will be start from the 1051, right? In that case, sequence number is 1051 to next packet will be start from the 1100, for next packet it will be 1100, right? So what is the sequence number? Sequence number is the first sequence number of your byte you are sending to the data. We have already done, in transport layer, TCP assigns byte number to each data, right? It is maximum of 32 bits. It will be randomly generated. First time, it will be randomly generated. After that, it will follow the sequence. Then, acknowledgement number. Acknowledgement number is sent by the receiver to acknowledge that data is received. For example, we will take this segment. When we deliver this segment, then it will send the data 1000 to 1050 bytes, right? at that time what acknowledgement number we will receive. We will receive the acknowledgement number 1051, right? What it will be sent? Last byte received plus 1. For example, last byte received number is X, so then ACK will be received for ACK X plus 1, right, students? So that ACK pointer, ACK number will be checked only when ACK flag is true. That we will discuss after the discussion of header length. Now next field is the header length. What is the header length? The total header length, because it vary from 20 to 60 bytes, right? It may be 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So header length is the 4 bits. 4 bits matlab maximum value will be 15. For header length, maximum value will be 15, 4 ones. But header sizes start from the 20 bytes to 60 bytes. It is actually the multiple of 4. If it is 15, then it will be multiplied by 4 equals to 60, means maximum header size, our header size is 60. That means header length value will be start from 0101, means 5 to 15. 5 into 4 equals to 20, right, because it is a multiple of 4. Before that, any value is the illegal value, that means it is corrupted, that will not be allowed. 0101, 0011, the value previously to 0101 is not allowed values, right. Next is the reserved bit. What is the reserved bit? Reserved bits are for future use, so that we are not going to discuss. And after that, I am going to discuss these 6 flag of 1 bit. All 6 flags have only 1 bit, right? They will be either 1 or the 0. These flags will be having value either 1 or 0. First, we will discuss the URG. URG means urgent. If URG value is 1, then urgent pointer value will be checked only then if URG bit is 1. If URG bit is 0, then urgent pointer value will not be checked. As name of flag predicts, urgent means something urgent data is sending to the receiver. It is immediately delivered to the application layer, right? Now in the segment, all data is not, it is not necessary ki all data is urgent, right? There may be some urgent data, some normal data. So urgent pointer value tells you, for example, I have written here 1020. Urgent pointer value is, for example, urgent pointer value is 1020. That means ki from the beginning of segment till 1020, data is urgent. After that, data of the segment is normal data. It will tell you the till where urgent data ends. ACK is 1. Then we came to know this packet contains the acknowledgement number also, right? Acknowledgement number we have already discussed, that is 1. If you send the 1050, then it will acknowledge 1051. Third flag is PSH flag. If PSH value is 1, if PSH flag value is 1, at that time there is 2 cases. One, for example, here is a sender, here is a receiver. When sender sets the value of PSH equals to 1, then transport layer sends the data to the network layer. TL send the data to the network layer and tell immediately transmit to the receiver. Right? And at the receiver end, when it founds that value is PSH value is 1, at that time receiver immediately deliver it to the application layer, transport layer to the application layer. These type of things is used in the chatting application, you can say. Here we can use the PSH flag. As soon as we send the message, that must be delivered to the receiver, where maximum segment size not matter for me. I want whatever message I will send to the receiver, that will be received immediately. Fourth flag is the RST flag. What is the use of RST flag? RST flag is basically immediately terminate the connection due to any error, due to any problem. We can disconnect the connection. This is the SYN flag. SYN flag is set 1 at the time of connection establishment. Whenever we establish the connection between sender and receiver, at that time, I already told you in the last lecture, we will establish the connection using the three-way handshaking. When you do the three-way handshaking, first sender will send the packet to the receiver. I want to establish the connection. At that time, SYN bit will be set 1. Right? It is used to synchronize the sequence number. At that time, random sequence number will be generated. From, I already told you random number value 2 to the power 32. This is wrong here. Minus 1 is here. 2 to the power 32 minus 1. Right. In that case, that value is set in the SYN flag. SYN flag is 1. And synchronization for synchronization of a sequence number, that sequence value will be sent initially. Right. SYN bit is set only 1 whenever we are establishing the connection. Otherwise, it will not be 1. Next is the FIN. FIN is the, that is the finish, you can say. FIN flag. FIN flag will used to the terminate the connection. We will set the FIN bit as 1 when we want to terminate the connection. Sender to receiver, then FFIN will be set to the true. After that, checksum, sorry, window size. Window size is same as the, window size is the size where user will tell that, user will tell ki how many data it will be, it can receive. That is used for the flow control. That will be to maintain the flow control. After that, checksum. Checksum is same as UDP. Urgent pointer I have already discussed. Last but not least, I want to discuss the options and padding. Options and padding value is used to add some values. For example, it may be window size, maximum window size, maximum segment size, or when we have, for example, we have the 30 bytes of header. Header must be of the multiple of 4 by 4. In that case, 2 bytes of zeros will be added to the options and padding to make it the multiple of 4. Right? In that case, we will use, or if you want to use the window size more than 16 bits, in that case, you also use the options and padding. I hope this lecture will be useful for you, students. Study carefully and ready for the next lecture.